welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. So I wanted to give you guys some product suggestions because when I was a new natural, I was buying everything that I saw on YouTube. Not everything worked, of course, but I did find some things that I know that if I want to go back to them now, I can go back to them and they will work. And some of them I have always kept in my stash. I mean, obviously I've kept them because you're going to see them in this video, but these products may just help you from becoming a product junkie if you're new to the natural hair game. Some of us have been in the game for a long time and we just tired of being a product junkie, tired of buying mess, but we like, girl, I really ain't found nothing that I really like. Love, you know what I'm saying? Or I have things that I love, but I want to try new things, but I ain't got time for nothing that don't work. So I'm going to go through some products, give you guys some suggestions. All of these will be products that are on the ground that you can go to the store today and purchase. So let's go. First, we're going to start with pre-pull. I love to pre-pull, and my favorite pre-pull is definitely the African Pride pre-pull. This will forever be in my stash as a Holy Grail store-bought pre-pull. It's just bomb. If you want to detangle your hair easily, pick this up. Helps me detangle my hair super fast, and if you have a deep conditioner you love but it just doesn't have enough slip, add some of this and it'll change the game. Moving on to shampoos, if you didn't cancel Shea Moisture, this is a really good shampoo. It has great slip, super duper good lather, and it also does make my curls pop because of the protein. This is a really good shampoo if you didn't cancel Shea Moisture. This hydrating treat from Garnier is like hella affordable. We talking $6. A little bit goes a long way. Has a great lather and is moisturizing. So I really like this and I say run to Target and pick it up. And this exotic Kool-Aid shampoo from The Main Choice gives you the best tingly feeling on your scalp. It's moisturizing and a little bit goes a long way. Really good shampoo. Moving on to co-washes, I have a couple of co-washes here if you like to co-wash. One is the One Love from The Do. I believe they are selling this in Target. If not, sorry. Really nice co-wash. Moisturizing, smells like bubblegum, has a nice like kind of lather to it, and I just love it. And one of my OG favorites is the Grow Wash from As I Am. Now, the other one that I've tried, of course, was the OG Coconut one, and I do like that one, but this one is my favorite. But I'm sure you can't go wrong with any of them. If you want to try a clay wash, girl, make you one. This will never fail you with a little aloe vera juice or oil and some ACV. Girl, your curls will be popping. Now, of course, we have to deep condition our hair. Now, this one from Shea Moisture, it's good for a good moisture protein balance, affordable, accessible. Definitely give it a try if you haven't. Cancel Shea Moisture. And OG is the TGIN Honey Miracle Mask. I love it. Great moisture. It does have silicones. If you don't want to use silicones, you can pass this one. But other than that, the moisture, honey, the softness, it's always going to be in the stash. Now, if you want to spend a little extra coin, pick up this Macadamia Deep Conditioner. They sell it in Sally's, but you can get it cheaper in Marshall's or TJ Maxx. This has great moisture. It's nice and thick and creamy, and it's one of my favorites. Moving on to leave-ins, I'm going to show you guys a couple of lightweight leave-ins that I really like. And the first one is, of course, the Allocate Lemongrass Leave-In. This is just a great leave-in. No matter what style you do, it'll give you some nice, good moisture, nice, good base. Definitely check this out if you haven't, and plus it smells great. Another lightweight leave-in that I have been loving is this Quench from Aunt Jackie's. This one actually shocked me when I used it. I thought it wouldn't really do anything, but it had great slip, bomb moisture, and had my curls juicy and popping. Now, this one is between like creamy and lightweight. This one is the Untangle Me Leave-In from Jane Carter. The slip, honey, is amazing on this. And it gave me really good moisture as well. This is still one of my faves. It has glycerin, so I use it in the colder months. So I got a new one for the cold weather. And for a creamy leave-in, the TGIN Green Tea is just an OG. It has great moisture, great texture, gives you moisture throughout the week. And I mean, you gotta try this if you haven't. And everybody that has would probably agree. This is the Goddess Strength from Carol's Daughter. It doesn't smell that great and it does have silicones, but the moisture makes up for it. It does give you really good moisture, and the moisture did last all week. Now for my twist out braid out girls, I got you. This Lemongrass Twist Butter from Allocate is amazing. Like, love it. You use this on top of the leave-in, honey, your braid out twist out will be moisturized, shiny, and defined. This is the Texture ID Coils Twist Butter, and it's more of like a cream gel consistency instead of like a butter, But it gives you great definition. You do need to use a moisturizing leave-in underneath it, but it will give you some great definition and hold. Now, I know a lot of us like to do our braid outs and twist outs with mousse, so I'll show you guys some nice mousses. Of course, the Lotta Body mousse is bomb. Like, it's super affordable. It gives you a really good hold. Make sure you use a moisturizing leave-in underneath, and honey, you will have a nice definition. These mousses from TGIN will give you some really nice definition. This is the rose water one, and this is the honey whipped one. I use the honey whip for a rod set and this one for Bantu knot outs. They both gave me really good definition. Make sure you use something moisturizing underneath both of them. And lastly, this one from the Main Choice. This is the pink lemonade mousse, and this was really good as well. Gave me great definition and hold. It's really sticky though, so if you don't like sticky mousses, you might not like this one, but if you don't mind, it's definitely worth trying. Now for gels. Now y'all don't click off, because I know how y'all be about this, but this Cantu avocado gel is good. Now I've only used their avocado line. I've never used any other Cantu products, but this gel from that line really gave me a nice wash and go. I'll definitely leave that video for you guys, but this was really good. It's a nice thick gel, hella affordable, so I mean, I recommend it. Y'all knew I was not going to talk about gels without talking about Wet Line. This is definitely one of my favorites, and I mean, for every reason. It gives you great definition, hold, it's hella affordable, accessible, and look how much product you get. So like, girl, you can never go wrong with this. And last for gels, this Ice Curls by Aunt Jackie's is really, really nice. My wash and go was popping, shiny, defined, and I'm here for this gel. Now if you got a little coin to spend, girl, go on and get you some Camille Rose curl maker, okay? Because it's just that good. It pretty much works with everything. It never flaked up on me, but I heard that it can be finicky with some people, but it's never flaked up on me, and I have used it with different leave-ins. The best one to use it with is the Curl Love by Camille Rose. That's also a great leave-in. I'm out of it, need more of it, but yes, that's a great combo. And also the Curly Magic from Uncle Funky's Daughter, great slip, great definition, great moisture, like, girl. And lastly, this oil from Melanin is one of my favorite oils. I know people say an oil is an oil is an oil, but I beg to differ, especially when it comes to this oil. I really enjoy this oil. Nice, lightweight oil. You can use it as much as you want, and your hair doesn't feel greasy, at least not for me. And I love the citrusy smell. This shine spray from Afro Sheen does show up and show out if you have a style that just needs that little bit of oomph, that little bit of shine, because it's just not all the way there for you. Spray some of this on there, girl. Them curls will be glistening. They'll look super hydrated, and you'll love it. So I know that was a lot of products. Hopefully I didn't overwhelm you guys, but I did want to give you guys some options. You guys make sure you leave your favorite affordable and accessible products for a beginner or for everybody down in the comments. Please like this video, share, and subscribe, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye.